Greetings, programs. This is Wretch. Welcome back to Hogwarts Legacy. And in the last episode, guys, we decided to give the battle arena a try. And after about 15 to 20 minutes of just flat-out combat with armored trolls and goblins and tons of other unsavory characters, we were able to get through it and got no reward. So Daniel learned a very valuable lesson that day. So, we were able to explore a little bit more, got some areas of power taken care of here south of Irondale and near Feldcroft. We're going to be taking care of one more that's over here, and then we're actually going to head to Feldcroft and go search it and maybe even talk to Sebastian, guys. It's an exciting day. Anything can happen. I just keep on getting sidetracked. I feel so bad for those characters that are just like, hey, I'll meet you over here for the next part of our adventure. Daniel's like, okay.
I don't waste time seeing if they're dead.
2 years later.
Face not on my hands.
Oh, that's a guide page. I think, maybe. Well, let's not fall off the edge.
Revelio.
Oh, just the area of power. Looks like we got some level 31 baddies. And we're gonna have to navigate through the middle of this. I'm glad it's not like World of Warcraft where if they're a higher level than you, then they can almost instantly see through your stealth.
Let's finish this job.
Something's not
I heard something.
Y'all just want to keep on keeping on. Anyone else? Oh. Lovely.
Patricus Totalus.
Brave? Ha ha! I'd say we know who to leave at home minding.
Laceration 3.
Revelio.
Well, that's this camp pretty much cleared. Let's see, can we go ahead and deal with you? And
Petrificus Totalus. I did it. And an Ashwinder no less.
Good job, good job.
Revelio.
Now, where's the rest of our power? Aha. Got stuck. Ray Quidditch Club. We're fine, Daniel. Drop down. And we got our ancient power raised up to 4 bars, which is stellar. Still have quite a few to go, but definite progress. Okay. So now that that's cleared, we'll leave the Merlin Trials where they lie for now. Let's go ahead and start exploring Feldcroft. Well, it is nighttime. Maybe we can find the demiguys. Apparently there's just one. Not in here.
Revelio.
Grab that money, though. Someone's a accomplished Quidditch player. I am going to assume. Let's just run from room to room, or house to house. That's where Sebastian's hanging out. It's got like a little watchtower. Practical.
Revelio.
There's a note there. There you are.
Fine now then.
Aloha Mora.
And our Like, it's normally nighttime. I've decided that I'm going to try and have a lot of episodes be during the daytime so y'all can see better. But you have to grab Rebellion. Those things when we see them. Natural terrain? I did notice we are getting a lot of stuff around here, specifically for the outside of the Room of Requirement. Avian Brown Wand? Get that guide page.
Revelio.
Actually, practice some self-defense here. Practice dummies. The residents of Felcroft sometimes use these to practice their spell casting, especially in light of recent goblin attacks. That's good to know. They're not just sitting there playing, or being a victim. Not playing a victim, but being one. They're like, you know what? We're gonna fight back. Someone tries to deal with us. We'll deal with them right back. And unidentified item.
Revelio.
I'm okay with that. It's usually a big upgrade, especially out of those boxes. Okay. And we already went in there. That's where we saw the Quidditch stuff. We talked to the... Did we talk to the vendor here? No, we've never...
Nice to see you again.
Oh, yes, we did.
Nice to see you as well. How can I help you?
I'm curious to know what's happening in Feldcroft. Might you have any insight?
An incredibly unpleasant goblin called Belgroth the Bludgeoner has been tormenting everyone he encounters. Feldcroft borders goblin country. But we've always lived in peace with their kind. Until recently, that is. Some claim that Belgroth and his associates are in league with Ranrok. I don't know if there's truth to it. Whatever the case, their constant meddling is devastating business. Everyone feels unsafe. It's quite serious.
What do you sell here?
Glad you asked. I sell the finest array of beast byproducts you'll find in the entire countryside. If you don't believe me, feel free to look about. Eventually you'll return. They always do.
What brought you to own a shop in Feldcroft?
Beautiful place, isn't it? Although I admit, I didn't choose it. It chose me. I was raised here. It's always been my home. As for the shop, I suppose my line of work chose me as well. I've always loved working with beasts. And my twin girls adore them.
Aww.
Wouldn't be surprised if they took over from me one day.
The family business.
I should be going now. Thank you.
Revelio.
Okay, cool. Now, we saw there was lore over here, right? Or in one of these places. A door was locked and there were... Yes. What is this? Letter from Sebastian Sallow to his sister Anne. Dear Anne, Hogwarts isn't the same without you. Well, Sharp is still a foul, but you know what I mean. I hope you're feeling better, Sebastian. This is the residence, huh? Well, that must be her. Hello. Don't mind me. A letter from Anne to Sebastian. Sebastian, this is my potion kit, not yours. Leave my things be, Anne. Guy in here doing
Revelio.
Experiments. Would that be a papa? Black fingerless gloves? Oh. Oh, hold on. Fingerless gloves are always the way to go. Let's see. Where'd you go? Black fingerless gloves. Let's see what they look like. Nope, actually the plain black gloves look good. It doesn't work with what the kind of aesthetic that we have. If we did any kind of sword play in this game, I'd probably be
Revelio.
All about it, but okay, let's take a final flight around, and then you know what? Let's go ahead and talk to Sebastian. Teal and brown. All the wands. And is this part of town? Doesn't look like
Revelio.
An old blacksmith shop. Pretty 6. Got another well here. Not the talkative sword either. Alrighty. Been a long wait, Sebastian. But it is time. Oh, maybe we're gonna go ahead and take out that castle. Only one way to find out. Time to wait.
You made it.
Oh yeah, we're so taking out that castle. Look at him.
Enjoying the view.
Keeping an eye on things. Feldcroft isn't what it used to be. No one has felt safe here since Ranrock's loyalists took a peculiar interest in that castle over there. Rookwood Castle. My uncle Solomon is a former Aura and refuses to look into it, even after Anne was cursed by one of them. Possibly with a wand, no less.
I heard a goblin refer to wizard kind as wand carriers. Are goblins forbidden from carrying wands?
Precisely. That's why I'm on the hunt for answers. If I'm to cure her, I need to understand what happened to her. Anne was always the most mischievous of the three of us. Which is saying something, knowing me and Ominous. I'm hoping a surprise visit from me and a new friend from Hogwarts will help lift her spirits. Bring back the Anne I used to know. Come on, I'll take you to my uncle's. This way.
Must have been to the uncle, working on stuff in the lab.
Feldcroft used to be a lot livelier.
It's not too bad.
With Ranrock's lot wandering about all the time, everyone stays out of sight. Here we are. My sister should be just inside.
Well, we've met. Kind of.
Aha! Sebastian, where did you... Is that what I think it is?
We've been over this, boy. Hey. Shrivel figs cannot reverse a curse. Nothing can. The sooner you accept that reality, the better.
But we haven't tried everything.
There is no cure! When will you accept that?
Never! I can never accept it.
Now look what you've done.
What he did?
I'm sorry.
Leave. Oof.
I'm sorry you had to see that. If you don't mind, I just need a moment alone.
Poor Sebastian. Not the visit he'd hoped for.
Speak with Anne and Solomon. No, necessarily I want...
Sorry about earlier.
Talk to Solomon.
Those bouts of pain are difficult to bear.
Are you all right, Anne? I didn't mean to intrude.
You didn't, truly. And I'm all right. The pain from this curse comes in bouts, and often suddenly. It's not anyone's fault. It's nice to meet you, by the way. You must be the new fifth year Sebastian told me about.
I am. Sebastian and I met on my first day at Hogwarts, in the Slytherin common room.
Oh, the common room. Oh, I adored teasing first years about spotting mermaids through the window. I do miss Hogwarts, but I wouldn't mind being in Feldcroft, really, if it wasn't so dreary now. Between the goblins at the castle and my uncle fighting with Sebastian whenever he's home, it's not the cozy retreat it once was.
Sebastian mentioned something about your uncle being an ex-Auror, but refusing to go after Ranrock's loyalists. I must say, I wasn't prepared for him to be as angry as he was.
Uncle Solomon is frustrated by what happened to me, and by Sebastian for thinking he can fix it. They both mean well, I know they do, but my uncle is right. This curse cannot be undone. I can feel it. Sebastian cannot take away my pain. Perhaps you can help him to understand that.
I'll do my best. I can promise to speak with him about it.
Thank you. His search for a cure is futile, I'm afraid. I'm getting tired. I should probably rest. Thank you for stopping by.
Looks like Daniel needs
to wish you well.
See this for himself. Let's talk to Captain Charisma here.
That boy will fray my last nerve.
Excuse me, Mr. Sallow.
Oh, yes, Sebastian's friend. I apologize on behalf of my nephew. He doesn't know when to stop. I was about to check on Anne. Did I see you come from the house? How is she?
She's all right. She said she was going to rest.
Nothing can be done for her.
It could be that you've not yet discovered the cure.
Ah, you sound like Sebastian, thinking you know better than the healers at St. Mungo's.
Perhaps the healers don't know everything, sir. Sebastian is single-mindedly focused on finding a way to help his sister. If there is a cure, he will find it.
Your faith in Sebastian is misplaced. Some sort of dark magic cursed Anne, and the goblins aren't likely to explain themselves any time soon. Giving her hope is cruel. The only thing to do now is keep Anne comfortable and stay out of the loyalists' way.
With all due respect, sir, hope could keep Anne's spirits up.
You may mean well, but I know what's best for Anne and Sebastian. They are my stubborn brother's children. Especially Sebastian. If you really want to be of help, you'll make sure Sebastian does what he should do, not what he wants to do. He's no idea the harm he could do if he doesn't stop. I hope you'll remember what I've said. Good day.
I ought to see how Sebastian's faring.
Yeah, we're... Okay, stop over here.
Why will he not listen to me? She's my sister.
How are you doing, Sebastian?
You got a first-hand glance at what I'm dealing with. I apologize for my uncle.
He is trying to do what's right, but how he handled it.
I'll admit, I wasn't expecting him to be so angry.
He's always angry. He's been angry since my parents died. After Anne was hurt, he only grew worse. It's as though he blames me somehow, always calling me my father's son, as if that's an insult. I'm the one trying to help her. He's simply given up.
Both Anne and your uncle seem genuinely convinced that nothing more can be done for her.
I refuse to believe that. Anne's pain is more than physical. It has changed her entirely. I miss my sister. And I'm going to get her back. Come with me. I need to show you where it happened.
Scene of the crime.
Ranrock's loyalists are capable of so much more than people realize. They should not be underestimated.
Let's go.
All the debris you'll see is from whatever's going on at that abandoned estate. They've been digging for something.
As long as Sebastian doesn't have a hatred for all goblin kind, it's kind of warranted. His
up
hatred
there,
of Ranrock, at least.
On that plateau is where they cursed Anne. This way.
So we were just there. I assume it's going to be swarming with goblins now.
Oh, my much longer are we expected to dig through this rubble?
Ramrock knows what he's doing. It's an honor to be a part of it.
Oh, hello.
Leviosa,
Descendo, Confringo, Expelliarmus.
Mm hmm.
Ranrock, well, you're
nice.
Thanks for the help.
Who's there? Someone there?
You know what? Well, that was overkill.
I won't rest.
Confringo.
Still alive? There you go.
You've made your last mistake.
Hello, friend.
I'll bury you in the deepest
descender. Leviosa, Confringo, Expelliarmus. Protego,
for the coward.
Descendo,
stop it.
Leviosa, Descendo, Confringo.
No,
stupid.
One less human to worry about.
Just your own medicine?
Leviosa, Descendo. Confringo.
Expelliarmus.
Protego, stupid one.
You regret such arrogance.
Leviosa, Descendo, Confringo.
Like, you have met Slytherin House, right?
Get it?
Protego.
Oh, woman.
Confringo. Leviosa,
Descendo, Confringo,
Expelliarmus.
Losing your stride.
Ooh, you got a double hit.
Leviosa. Descendo.
I confess, that was a bit more than I'd bargained for. I tried to warn you.
Well, don't. That was fun.
Reparo.
Let's keep a cart for the city.
Those loyalists deserved what they got.
Couldn't agree more. This is where it happened. We smelled smoke in the middle of the night. When we looked outside, flames were shooting from the estate. Before my uncle and I could stop her, Anne rushed out, racing towards the fire, worried someone had been hurt. She came face to face with a horde of goblins, frantically trying to stamp out the flames. Suddenly, an icy voice drifted out from somewhere in the smoke. Children should be seen and not heard. A blinding blast followed. They didn't even give her a chance to run.
It seems an awfully violent response to a child wandering by. What were they trying to hide?
My thoughts exactly. It may be grasping at billywigs, but I keep thinking that there might be something here that could lead me to whoever cursed Anne. Might be the only way to learn what type of magic harmed her, which could help me find a cure.
Perhaps you're right. The loyalists are everywhere, but they do seem to be spending a lot of time here, and it's likely they're hiding something.
And at Rookwood Castle. Shall we have a look around? They seem to have set up camp here for a specific reason. They have stations for everything.
Revelio.
Clues.
I've heard that goblin dig sites like these are popping up everywhere.
It's a wonder the Ministry isn't doing more. Whose home was this?
Been abandoned long since I've lived here. Rumor was, a Hogwarts professor lived here once, centuries ago. But that's all I ever heard.
Ooh. Well, we have Rookwood Castle there. could be the older Rookwood.
Always armed and ready for a fight, Ranrok's loyalists.
Revelio!
It's worth taking a closer look at the house itself.
Get to actually observe the well.
This well looks familiar.
Something to add there, Sebastian?
Sebastian, over here. Do you think that this was damaged by the fire the night that Anne was cursed?
Could be. But it looks to me as though this was intentional.
Revelio.
Sebastian, I've seen this before. This house, the well, the view.
What do you mean? When?
Oh, the old
Give
vision.
Give me a moment. I'll explain in a second.
Gotcha. When the famine or whatever was reversed.
Sebastian, this house did belong to a Hogwarts professor hundreds of years ago.
Who? What do you...
I found a pensive that day in the restricted section with a memory that showed this house. There was a little girl and a drought. The keepers have shown me other memories as well. The girl became a Hogwarts professor. Her name was Isadora Morganarch. She was one of the keepers.
The keepers? Like in Quidditch? And you found a pensive in the library? I'm not following you.
I realize it's a lot to take in. I'm not even sure I understand it all yet. And no, not like Quidditch. They call themselves keepers because they're protecting some type of knowledge. It has to do with the vault at Gringotts.
Let me see if I've got this straight. You have Ranrok and Rookwood after you because of something you found at Gringotts where you ended up via a portkey. And now you've been witnessing memories left by keepers. Oh, and this house belonged to a Hogwarts professor who was one of these non-Quidditch keepers hundreds of years ago.
Thumbs it up.
If I didn't know you, I'd think you were pulling my leg.
It is all a bit much, isn't it, when you put it like that? The point is, we both have good reason to search this house. You for answers about what happened to Anne, and me for answers about the keepers.
Look at this.
Revelio.
Someone piled this here for a reason. Is it blocking something?
Only one way to find out.
Revelio.
Ah, it's where the magic happens.
Why bother blocking a stairwell?
There might be something here worth a closer look.
They've left all of this simply strewn about. Tells me they're after something bigger.
Oh, we got freaking devil weed. Isadora Morganarch Journal, 1 of 7. It is my second week in the camp. More arrive each day. The Muggle doctors and even some of our own healers are doing all they can for them. The grief is palpable. The ones who have survived the plague are forever damaged by their loss. A fever may pass, the skin may mend and scar, but the devastating sorrow remains. I saw a man, much like my father, who had lost a child. I couldn't bear it. I longed to give him some shred of relief. I'm beginning to think that the others are wrong. I have the power to help these souls. It seems as arbitrary not to help them as it would be to rid them of their torment.
A journal entry of Isadora's. I should hold on to this.
I traveled here to learn, but I long to help. My internal struggle is overwhelming. It's as though the magic wants to heal and I'm the one preventing it from doing so. Should I lose hope? Will I forever regret not having done more? I cannot look into their eyes knowing that I could lessen the burden of heartache. I saw the man leaving camp today, the one who so reminded me of my father. Surely it wouldn't hurt to help him. I could further my research, of course, but that would be a fortuitous consequence of doing something good with this ability.
Seems these journal entries are from Isadora's travels.
Revelio.
More stuff.
Confringo! Revelio.
You're not going to believe this. I can see the Undercroft.
What? A daydream? Because that happens to me too.
I know it sounds strange, but
honestly, Nothing you say sounds strange to me anymore.
Fair enough. I can see the Undercroft through this stone wall, as though it's a window. This has happened before.
I'm listening.
I have a rare ability to see whispers of ancient magic.
I don't know what I was expecting you to say, but it wasn't that. I knew you weren't telling me everything. Ancient magic. What does that even mean?
I'm not entirely sure, but the Keepers have said that it's a powerful magic that should only be wielded by a select few.
And you can wield it?
I don't know, but Fig and I think that Ranrok has somehow found a way to harness that magic's power.
Are you telling me that goblins may be wielding some sort of wizard magic?
That's what we're trying to find out. What I do know is that my ability allows me to travel through these windows I see.
Wait. We can get straight to the Undercroft from here. Ominous will be floored.
We can. But perhaps best not to tell anyone else about this for now. Even Ominous.
Understood. Well then, invisible, secret, ancient magic passageway, here we come.
He's taking it in stride.
I'm tempted to hold my breath.
Let's go. Right through those runes.
Why would the door lead us here?
Sebastian, look.
Another chamber? Oh. First clue is on the left.
Why hide a triptych here?
Seems as if something's missing.
A note. Let's have a look.
It's like coordinates, maybe? Part of a compass?
Anything helpful in the note?
Good lord, no.
A rune symbol. I've seen similar symbols used by the Keepers.
I've been thinking. A Keeper lived in that house centuries ago, and Ranrok and his lot have been searching there. You said that goblins may be wielding some form of this ancient magic. Do you think Anne was cursed by ancient magic?
I can't be sure, of course, but I don't think so. I didn't see any traces of it around your sister.
Hmm. Very well. But that doesn't mean it's not ancient magic. There's still so much we don't know about it.
True. Perhaps this triptych will lead us to answers.
Then we'll have to unravel what this all means. But now I need to see Ominous. Don't worry, I won't tell him anything. Did I mention that, apparently, Salazar Slytherin had a secret scriptorium here, in Hogwarts?
You did not? Is it connected to our common room?
No idea. Ominous just learned of it. I'll let you know what I find out. I had no idea our visit to Cian would unfold into all of this. My head's an utter mess. But I'm glad you told me everything you did.
I really like Sebastian.
I'll be in touch. Till then.
In the shadow of the estate. Finally got that done. Alright guys, well, this seems like a good place to go ahead and call it an episode. We get back, we'll see what else we can do. I hope y'all... Oh, we got...
Meet me near the ruins of Falbarton Castle. After dark, do not tell anyone.
Let's get our messages here. Anything else? No? Okay. So, yeah. Definitely good to continue Sebastian's storyline and get a little bit more info about what exactly Ranrok is after. But I hope y'all have enjoyed the episode. If you liked it, please leave a like down below. Subscribe to the channel, leave a comment, that'd be a big help. And we'll see you next time. Later days, everyone.